3 weeks ago, I made a tutorial teaching you how to create a roll dice game named Dicer. Some of you asked me to add some animation to the dice with a check animation when the user clicks on the roll dice button. So I decided to create a version 2 to add the check animation. A roll dice game is a simple game in which you have to roll dice and trying to make the highest score possible by adding the values of the two dice. To start, we need to have 6 images for the 6 values of each dice from 1 to 6. You can see the dice images on the screen. The next step is to create the user interface of our roll dice game. We add a linear layout with 2 image view components. Each image view component will be used for a dice. We set dice images to have a preview of our user interface in the corresponding view. You can click on the design view to have a preview of the user interface with the boss dice. Then we add a button which will be used to let the user to start to roll dice by clicking on it. We center horizontally the button and we can have a preview by clicking on the design view. Okay, it looks great. In this version 2 of the tutorial, the novelty is that we are going to create a check animation for our devices. So we create the check animation in an anim folder in the resources folder of our Android project. The animation file will be named check.xml. We create a set of effects with a rotate effect and a translate effect at the same time to give the user the check illusion on the screen. We set the duration of the animation. We add a linear interpolator to improve the check effect. and we had a translate animation with the same duration and also a linear interpolator to improve the effect. Now we can write the Java code of the main activity of our roll dice game. First, we define a static random object which will be used to generate random values for the dice. Then we define fields for the button view and boss image views. We create a static random dice value method to generate a random value between 1 and 6. In the onCreate method, we get references for our three view components. For the button and boss image views. Then we set an onClick listener implementation on the roll dice button. When the user will click on the button, the onClick method will be called. We create an animation listener implementation, and just before, we load the check animation for both dice. We create an anim1 variable and an anim2 variable to load two check animation. Then we create an animation listener implementation. In the onAnimationEnd method, we generate random dice value by calling the randomDiceValue method. Then we use the getIdentifier method of the resources object to get dynamically the resources of the associated dice image. Then we set the new image on the correct image view reference by checking if the current animation corresponds to animation 1 or 2. We set The animation listener instance created on each animation, anim1 and anim2. And finally, we start the animation with animation1 in parameter for the first image view. And we make the same for the second image view by calling the startAnimation method with the anim2 parameter. The code written, we can try our roll dice game by clicking on the run button on Android Studio. We wait during the Gradle build. OK, the APK is installing and the activity will be launched quickly. So now we can click on the roll dice button and enjoy the final result with the check effect on the dice and the new values displayed at the end of the animation. It works great. Great effect for a dice game. That's all for that tutorial. Don't hesitate to subscribe to the SRL channel if you want to discover more Android development tutorials. If you want to contribute to the channel, you can contact me in comments or via email to sylvain.sorel@gmail.com.